everyone, this is Trisha, and tonight I'm going to be making you some dinner. I'm going to be making a sopa de conchitas con pollo. This is a small shell pasta with some chicken. It is something that my mother used to make for my brother and I as we were growing up. It's something that she still kind of makes, but I decided that I wanted some, so I'm going to go ahead and make some and show you how I do that. So I'm going to move this camera down so you can see what I'm doing. I've got my little burner out here ready. And I've got some chicken that I've already gone ahead and cooked, so let's get to cooking. Okay, so in this pan, I've gone ahead and I've boiled some chicken thighs, and I've left them on the bone and with their skin. So they've created a nice chicken broth in here. I've got, let's see, there's 6 chicken thighs in here. You could do chicken breast if you prefer to use that, but I feel like the dark meat gives this particular dish a nice flavor, so that's what I decided to use. And of course, I'm going to be using all that delicious broth in there also. So I'm going to go ahead and start preparing some of my ingredients before I go ahead and, you know, just decide to take off all the meat off the bones and take the skin off and such. So let's go ahead and move this out of the way. Over here. Okay, let me clean up my little counter here. A little bit of mess. I'm wearing a white shirt and I feel like I'm going to get it all stained, but that's okay. You know, I'm just at home relaxing, and I decided that, you know, I wanted this delicious type of food. I have some ideas and some other things that I want to do, but this, I had all the ingredients, so that is why I'm making this. So I'm just going to chop up some onion, and I guess we could do a little chit-chattering while I'm doing this. I'm going to chop up about a quarter onion. Well, that was a quarter onion, so this is half of that, so about an eighth of an onion. But this is a really big onion. So if you had a small onion, or if you had a medium onion, I guess you would be doing like about a quarter onion. This is for 2 people, by the way. So I'm not going to be using all those thighs. I'm probably just going to use like maybe 3 and shred them up for my husband and myself. Okay, so now I'm just going to chop up some tomatoes. Get those ready as well. And I have my little plastic Ziploc bag here where I had my onion, where I had already opened it, or actually cut into it, peeled and cut into it. And I just put it all in this little Ziploc bag and I stick it back in the fridge. And I feel like that keeps it pretty nice. I guess I could buy myself with them little containers that are specially made for, you know, your onions. And I have done that in the past, but then I forget that I have it. And then, you know, you end up storing it in some drawer and it just stays in there. You forget you have it. I did once, did use it, and I forgot about it. It was in the fridge, and even though I'd see it, I'd forget about it. And that onion kind of went bad inside the little container. So, you know, just didn't use it. This little tomato's squirting out at me. So I don't know if I have anything on my top yet. Look, it's all wrinkled. I didn't even iron it. Been doing stuff. We've been remodeling our bathroom. It's actually finished now, but now I need to go in there and paint because we didn't ask for it to be painted. That was just something that occurred to me after the fact that it should be painted. So I'm doing it. My husband and I have been doing it. My husband's already kind of started on it and did the taller areas that I can't reach. So I'm just doing the bottom part. Okay, so I've got my tomatoes. Got 2 Roma tomatoes chopped up. I like a lot of tomato. And I had a little bit left over of the serrano pepper. So I'm going to chop up a little bit of that as well. And of course, you make sure you wash your hands real good afterwards. Because you don't want to get that, you don't want to rub your eye or even your mouth, your lips. That could hurt. Okay, I'm used to cooking with it, so it's happened, you know, where I do touch some part of my face and it hurts, but you know, live and learn. Okay, throw this away. Get a little plate to put all that on. Well, it's not really a little plate. Okay. Put my onions. My tomato, and then of course my serrano pepper. So now I'm going to take that chicken, and it's still hot, but I'm gonna go ahead and take that and let me get this knife in here and shred some of it. Let me show you the pasta that I'm gonna be using. This is small shell conchitas, is what it's called. Just a little bag, it's a 7.05 ounce bag. I might not even use the whole thing. Okay, let's get some of these. Maybe three. And then I'll just put the other three away, maybe make some chicken salad sandwiches for tomorrow or something. Some nachos would be good with this, or some chicken tortilla soup. Okay. Cover that up. Yep, it's hot. Let me get a fork. Okay, let's see. Sometimes a fork helps, sometimes it doesn't. Okay, get that skin off. Try to get a little bit of the little fatty bits off. Just slides right off. Get that little piece of chicken there. Ooh, it's hot. Hot, hot, hot. Maybe I need a second fork. That it just kind of like falls apart. Let me go ahead and get a second fork, or maybe the knife. Let's see. That kind of helps to kind of shred it up a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and turn on my pan here. There we go. I'm gonna put it on high so it starts to get hot. And I'm gonna use extra virgin olive oil. You could use vegetable oil, canola oil, even corn oil if you want. My mom used to use vegetable oil, or sometimes even some pork lard, you know, way back when that was a thing to use, or shortening like Crisco. And then, you know, oils came around and that's what people started using. Vegetable oils, that is. Let's get some of this little bits out of here too. So anyway, like I was saying, we just started off with our shower actually. Had our tub removed and did a shower, a tiled shower put in. And it came out really nice. I'm very happy with it. But then that turned into, oh, well, let's replace the vanity. And now it's turning into painting the bathroom. And that's turning into, well, now we got to do the other bathroom. So I've been, I did a little project. You saw my video where I did that mirror. And that's in that bathroom now. But I wanted to show you the other things that I'm going to do. So for next Tuesday, I'll have another video. A couple of little things that I'm making to put in the bathroom. And some of the items that I bought to put in there. So just kind of like do a little fun video that way. Something different. Okay, and this is sort of kind of also different, this little video. Of course, there's those people that don't like all that talking, just get to the food. And then there's some of you that like to visit, so we're visiting. Okay, let's take that off, and I think that's good. That's a lot of chicken, three thighs. Look at that. It's quite a bit. Okay, you know what, I'm gonna put it, I don't know if it'll fit in this one cup thing, but I'm gonna put that in there so we can just kind of measure. Okay, so that's one cup, and I'm pretty sure there's another cup here. So there's pretty much two cups of chopped chicken that's gonna go into my dinner. The little veins off. There's nothing wrong with eating them, obviously, but I don't really like them. I don't like just to see them in my food. Okay, so anyway, get this. Gotta throw that away. Those are the behind the scenes. I gotta wash my hands. Okay, so I've got my pan going. And that's hot, so I'm just gonna lower it to medium. And this is the way that my mom would prepare our little pastas. That's about, I don't know, a tablespoon to two, almost two, 1.5 or so of oil in the pan. And this is what she would do. Well, let's open this up first. Let's get my scissors, actually. I just rinsed my hands. I didn't wash them with soap, so they feel a little bit slippery. Oops, I didn't grab the scissors. Okay, so in the oil, it's really hot now. Yeah, good enough. Let's get these onions in there, and we're gonna start sauteing them. Keeping an eye so we don't burn anything. Let me move this a little closer so you can see what I'm doing. Wow, could have cut my fingers there with that knife. And if I lift this, to my stove stops. So I just want to show you real quick what the onions are looking like. This is a pretty neat little convection oven, or oven, not a convection, it's an induction cooktop is what it is. Wow. Okay, it's an induction cooktop. It's from Copper Chef, and I love it, and I got it for the purpose of the videos, so that when I'm cooking, instead of cooking over there where it's a little dark over there, my stove, I can cook here on my island and have a better camera view of things. Obviously, this is not like my usual videos where I bring a camera and show you, because I'm doing a little bit of a chit-chat. Okay, just a little different. Okay, so now I'm gonna throw my little shell pastas in there. And like I said, I'm not gonna use it all. I'm gonna use about half a bag. If you're cooking for a family of four, maybe even six, throw in the whole little bag in there. But it's just the two of you, just about half a bag. Okay, so what I want these to do is I want to get them toasted. So all my little pastas, my little shell pastas, to get nice and toasty in there, and that gives them a really nice flavor, almost like a nutty little flavor. I don't have any other better way to describe that, but a little toasty, nutty flavor, I guess. And we're gonna let that toast up, and then I'm gonna add the tomatoes and we'll season it. I have an item here that I use a lot. This is from Knorr. It is a caldo de tomate con sabor de pollo. It is a tomato bouillon with a chicken flavor. It tells you right there. And I buy this big giant container, and I use that to flavor my sopas, my Mexican little dishes that I grew up with. And now that has a lot of flavor, this type of seasoning. So you kind of have to add a little bit at a time. You can't like just go all out and just pour a whole bunch, because it'll be a little salty, because it does have a lot of salt in there. So I won't need to put any salt in this. So I don't know why I have my salt here. And it's got pretty much, let's see, what kind of ingredients does it have? Salt, that's the first thing. And then glutamato. Well, I'm reading it in Spanish. Monosodium glutamate. Cornstarch, it's got sugar, beef fat, corn proteins, natural flavors from chicken fat, tomato powder, yeast extract, citric acid. Oh boy, let me see, does it get to anything good? There's a little bit of turmeric in there, some parsley, oh, and then just a bunch of other stuff that, you know, you probably don't want to read. So anyway, I got my cumin and my garlic powder here, and I've also got my pepper, because I don't see any of that mentioned in the ingredients, so I'm gonna add that in there, and I always do anyway. I also have a little can of tomato sauce has no salt added on there. So I don't need my salt, so I don't know why I grabbed that. Okay, let me go ahead and open that can of tomato while I'm toasting this up. And let's see if this new can opener will work. These are all behind the scene things that I do that you don't see. So everything seems like, oh, well, perfectly smooth and nice, but it's not. Okay, here we go. So something that could just take a few minutes to cook sometimes takes me an hour with all the little preparations that I do. Okay, so I just want to bring this up so you can see how the onions, oops, have toasted and some of the shell have toasted. Let's get the little piece back in there. We don't want to waste any of that. You just want to keep stirring it so it doesn't burn. Let me get one. Can you see that little shell, how it's getting the little toasty bit on it? Looks really dark, but I'm looking at it here, it's not really. I'm also missing a light up here in my light fixture, so it's a little dimmer than usual. Okay, so now let's go ahead and add the tomato. And the chili, of course, you don't have to add that in there. I like to add that in there, so you just leave that out. I'm gonna go ahead and add it in there. And of course, when you add chili into heat, that chili kind of lets a lot of the oils out, so that can also cause you to have maybe a sinus reaction, maybe make your eyes watery, maybe choke a little bit of cough. You have to be careful with that. And I use it a lot and I cook a lot with it, but that still happens. I can't say that you get used to it because, you know. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and season this with pepper. I'm actually gonna add a little drop of oil, just a little tiny bit, because it's a little dry and I want that tomato. That was quite a big drop, actually. I want that tomato to saute in that oil. Now, if I wasn't using this no tomate, I could go ahead and put some salt in there. Make it simple and just add pepper, salt, cumin, and garlic powder. Look, I've already got something on myself right here, of course. It never fails. I always get something on myself. I go out to dinner. Does that happen to you? Do you ever feel like you should be wearing a bib? We went out to dinner last night, and I was wearing a white t-shirt under another blouse, which was open. You see the t-shirt? And right away, I got some Cholula hot sauce that dripped on it. And it was at IHOP, so we also got some pancakes that came with our meal. And then I got some syrup on it, because, you know, had to get a little bit of chili and I had to get a little bit of that sweetness in there. Okay, I've used that. Now I want to use some garlic, and I usually add garlic powder almost toward the end of my sauteing process because I don't like it to burn. And I like a lot of garlic, and if you don't like to use the garlic powder, but you want to use fresh garlic, then even better. So I'm just going to saute this around. Okay, now I'm going to add this chicken in there, which is already cooked, so we obviously don't need that to cook, but we do want it to pick up a lot of that flavors from the tomato and the onions. Just yummy. There's a piece of chicken right there that wasn't broken up too well, and that's okay. All right. I'm gonna add about a tablespoon of this. And I just use a lid to measure, but of course, use your little measurements, little spoons to do that if you're not confident. Probably put less than what I'm adding, and then you can just adjust the flavor. So I'm adding it now because I want it to coat everything. I want it to get in there really well. That. All right. So I saw in the community comments because I forgot that we have that, and I had posted a question some time ago, like, do you have any suggestions and foods that you like me to see me make? And I got just like maybe 2 or 3 comments. People one that she just likes everything I make, so whatever, I guess. And another person put in there that they like Mexican food, my Mexican dishes. So I guess that's kind of basically what I kind of cook anyway. But then I also had someone ask for some like gluten-free type of Mexican dishes. And I'm gonna go ahead and research a little bit of that so I can make sure that I'm doing the correct thing, because I am by no means a dietitian and I don't know too much about that. But I do know that like rice, for example, carb is what they were asking for. Low in carbs. So it has a low carb content to it, but it's also a good type of carb. Corn tortillas is also starch, but it's low also. And it's also kind of like a fiber, so it, that's also a good type of carb for you. So really, like this year, well, this has a pasta, so obviously it's got some carbs in there. So this is probably not the type. Maybe you want to get some little shell pasta or fideo, which is a vermicelli. If you can find a low carb one, I don't know, because I've not really looked for that, but I should. And I will. I do know that they're a little more pricier, and that's probably why it hasn't caught my attention. Okay, I'm gonna get that chicken so I can get some of that broth out of here and add it in here. I added that tomato sauce. I guess you saw that happening. Let me get my cup. Get that in there. And I want this so that it starts cooking those little shell pasta. And a little bit more. And that's about 2 cups probably that I've added in there. And I still have a little bit in here, which I can put away, or maybe add more to this. Cover that up. Okay. So now, just gonna stir it around, make sure all the chicken's immersed in there. Let me pick it up. Let me just wipe this off here first. Let me pick it up so I can show you. There you go. Okay, so that pasta, that little shell pasta, takes maybe 10-15 minutes to cook. So I'm gonna go ahead and cover it. I'm gonna bring it up back to high because I wanted to bring it up to a boil, and then I'll lower the boil down to a medium. And well, I'm gonna go ahead and give it 10 or 15 minutes, and then I'll be back, okay? And we'll try it out. All right, so my sopa de conchitas con pollo is finished. This is my small shell pasta with some chicken. It smells delicious. I took a little taste earlier just to make sure I had seasoned it correctly, and it was perfectly fine for my taste. So make sure you taste yours and then just adjust your seasonings. I've gone ahead and I've already turned this off. So let's go ahead and get some on a plate here and give it a nice taste. As you can see, I've changed my spoon. And there you go. Take a look at that. That looks so beautiful, so hearty, so delicious. And of course, you gotta have a big old spoon, you know, because you wanna get lots of it. But this is really hot, and I feel like I'm gonna burn my tongue. So let's get a little bit of chicken, some pasta in there, a little tomato, a little bit of that broth. If you feel you want it brothier, just add more of that chicken if you boil your chicken in, or if you buy some separate chicken broth, or maybe just add some water in there, that'll be just fine. You could also saute the chicken in a pan instead of boiling it if you want to cook it that way. And in that same pan, add your onions, saute them with your cooked chicken. You know, once you've already broken it up, if you happen to use like chicken breast, for example, and then add your shells. Saute them in there all together, and then of course add your liquids, your seasonings and your liquids. Let's try this. I'm scared. Mmm. Mmm. I'm gonna recommend that you do this with the chicken thigh. It is so much better. And it's got that flavor that I grew up with. It was less expensive to have chicken thighs or drumsticks than it was to have chicken breasts. It still is. So that's what we kind of grew up on. So of course, this is a very nostalgic flavor for me. So I hope you want to try it the same way that I'm trying it. A little bit more. Okay, well, there's my recipe. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you would try it. I hope you enjoyed the little chit-chat. I didn't even show you my little fern. Look at that. Cute little mini fern. Got this at Walmart. Got some extra little succulents right here. Look at that. I don't want to get any of that dirt in my food, so I'm going around. Got one more. Let me show you that one too. Cute little things. Anyway, those are going to go out in my garden eventually. But I hope you enjoyed my recipe. Give me a big old thumbs up. I'm going to give myself a big old thumbs up. Leave a nice comment down below. Please make sure to subscribe. And thank you to those who have already subscribed. Please share this on your social medias. That would really help me out, and I really appreciate that. And I can keep these recipes and all these crafts can keep coming for you. I really enjoyed doing this, so I hope you enjoyed it as well.